I'm Old Sneelock. Welcome to another episode of Old Sneelock's Workshop. I promised you guys that I was going to do another video on sharpening files. And I want to go a little bit deeper into the process. There's been a lot of explanations and complaints and arguments back and forth. So I'd kind of like to set up some experiments to see if I can offer a little bit better definitive proof that it actually does do something to the file. And also how it works. Back about 2006, I read an article where a friend of mine explained how to sharpen a file using acid. Now, you know me, I go to auctions. I go to a lot of auctions and flea markets and antique shops and garage sales, and I've been doing that, oh man, a good 20 years. Probably longer than that. Closer to 28 years. In the process, I tended to go right to the last part of the auction because I was leaving work and the auction started about 10 o'clock. So by the time I got to the farmer's place to bid on anything, I was bidding on the last boxes of dreck and junk. I would bring them home and we'd open them up in the back of the truck, Ryan and Lydia and I, and we'd all have a little fun pulling things out of there saying, "What's this?" Well, in the bottom of the boxes were quite often files. Yeah, a big stack of files. Usually rusty and beat up and grungy, and a lot of those just got tossed in a drawer, and if I needed a file, I dug through until I found one that worked, and then I put it on the shelf. When I needed another file and that one was dull, I just dug through the box until I found another one. Jim Thompson showed me how I could sharpen them. And I thought, really? But Jim had never steered me wrong, so I listened to what he said and went through the process of getting a batch set up, ran them through some acid and tried them, and I'll be darned it worked. Now, I didn't go through the whole theory and wondering why it worked. I just knew that I started out with a file that wouldn't cut, and when I was done, it cut. Ipso facto, it worked. So I'm going to set up a little process and see if I can show you how it does work. I'm also going to be going through some files and sharpening them because I have dull files now. It's been almost, well, the last time I sharpened files was 2012 when I made the last video. So that's been 6 years. I don't dull them very quickly because I take care of them. I'll take these rusty, beat up, dull files that came from other sources. Yeah, these two came from the reed store. I talked about those. This one, I think, came from a garage sale. I don't remember exactly where, but it was an interesting size, and I thought this is a good one for an acid sharpening video. Not wanting to jump into anything, this one is about 2.5 years ago I picked this up. So stay tuned, watch, and we'll go through the process together and I'll try and show you exactly how it works. One of the things I like about this little vise is I can use it anywhere there is another vise. Locks in just as well over here as it does on that bench. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take a short chunk of this threaded rod, which is 5/8 of an inch in diameter. And these threads roughly correspond to the shape of file teeth. They're pointed, they're regular lines, and they're consistent in size. Besides that, I don't mind taking a piece of threaded rod and ruining it. Now this is going to be our sacrificial lamb. The reason I cut the threaded rod to this length, it just exactly fits across those raised bumps in the bottom of this plastic tray. And waste not, want not, these come with mushrooms in them. I like mushrooms. So we buy mushrooms and I keep the trays. I'm gonna put this in a bath of acid, and we're gonna look at the bottom part, which is sitting in the acid, and I'm gonna leave the top part free of the acid, and we'll see what happens to those teeth. But before I do that, I'm gonna purposely dull some of the teeth. Now this file is sharp. One side of this file is single cut, the other side is double cut. The double cut file. The teeth on this file reflect light from the edges. It takes a flat surface to reflect light. Just like the sharp edge of a jackknife doesn't reflect light, neither does a file with sharp edges. No light reflected there at all. So what we want to do when we're done is have these flat edges converted to sharp edges. In our test piece, I want to take these flat spots here and convert them to points. That roughly corresponds to this file, but it's much larger. I've been asked several times to make photomicrographs of a file. Trying to make photomicrographs of a file with the equipment that I have is terribly difficult. It's blurry. It's a small area. It's difficult to discern what's happening on a very small scale. So instead of going micro, I went macro. We're going to work with a much larger sample, but the activity is the same. The acid is going to eat every surface of this that is in contact with acid. And while it's doing that, it's going to sharpen this surface right here. So I take this same sample, I set it in the bath, and because this is going to be working with sulfuric acid, which is a lot more reactive than the vinegar that I normally use to clean parts to remove the rust, I'm going to do this outside. I'm not going to leave the camera on the part and let it sit there and bubble away. It's going to take several hours. That much data is just a waste of time. We're going to have to trust me that I'm not lying to you, because if I am, turn off the video right now and go someplace else and do something else. If you can't believe me, I don't need to have you here watching, because all you're going to do is just get pissed off. So that's the design of experiment that we're going to use. May not be perfect, but it's the one I've got right now. If you have any suggestions for a new video, questions about today's video, or any of the other videos on the channel, just drop a note in the comments. You know, I read them all. There's going to be a lot more to this series. It's not going to be just one video, because it's going to occur over several days. You're just going to have to keep coming back to see what happens. Thanks for watching.